Hi everyone, and welcome back. And happy to see you again. I'm François Arblay, and I know that it's been a while because after this long break, due to overload work, and also I got some so many personal engagement here, so that's why I just like I was out of the market. And I do my comeback with the last week with the weekly market fundamental analysis, but it's on French because you know that I alternate French and English on the different financial broadcasts. So I'm very happy to see you again. And you are now you are a custom because each Monday we find us to discuss each other on the financial charts, which is on Forex, commodity, bond, and all the stuff. So for people which is first discover me, my name is François Abli again. I'm the main trainer and founder of Global Street Trader Academy, GSTA. There, which is a bilingual Canadian online financial courses. You can also learn, and we teach you and take care about you. You will reframe that we speak to learn how to trade stock, bonds, indices, option, forex, and all the stuff, because I have a specialization of background of financial and economics. So yeah, I'll let you know that, and if you're interested, eventually you can keep in touch with us, and we'll discuss for your frame and your like also related to your educational and courses. Okay, so yeah, we find each Monday for discussing for financial markets, and after this long break, as I said, we are not going to directly to see which one the market we're very interested now to for trading. Here is the disclaimer on face of you. And I know that you know by heart the disclaimer, but I have to show you each after the beginning of each broadcast, because it's the rule. People that might have to an idea and be aware of the risk of the trading. So it is not a gambling, or unfortunately, or is not a game. You need to be like very well educated on that, and also take your time to learn all the basic and fundamental for this activity, and then you can starting to make profit on financial market. And again, if you're interested for that, though, please feel free to ask us, and we definitely here to getting know of that. Okay, so weekly market technical analysis from July, which is starting to the end today until the 14th, as I said, which is the 21 edition. And as usual, as I presented this financial broadcast is already based on summary and presented assets, and we see Forex, USD CAD, indices for Dow Jones and Google for commodity, and also bond for Eurobond, which is the weight of the debt, European debt, which is a high percentage of Germany debt and France, and also the Greece. Okay, Italia don't have like so much ponderation on that, but it's again, it's although the first the third country, the third biggest country in Europe after Germany and also up France, so they have like some an influence on that. Okay, so I will go directly to see what's happened on the graph. So as I used to do that, like each Monday before to move on other charts and other graph, I used to show you before the US dollar index chart, which is the most important chart that we can see ever on the financial market, because you know that all the chart are denominated and pairs as for US dollar, right? Forex as Forex, gold as also indices, and they are inverted correlated, or they can also be positive correlated or negative correlated. Okay, so here are the charts of US dollar index. But if it's the first time to see if it's some beginners of like first people, like people which is never see this kind of graph, don't be worried about that. It's just indicators, which is Ichimoku. Ichimoku is one of best indicator for trend line, and also to show the equilibrium on the market and one shot. That's the name said, Ichimoku Kinkoyo. We see that from the training through the GTP global trading program. But here I'll just want to show you many times that, and I want to show you again what's happened on there, because you remember that the last time that we discussed about the chart for Ichimoku, I know that due to the tightening policy of the Fed, and also the context of geopolitical risk of the supposed trade war and all the stuff, macroeconomics data, and also the news on the society, the biggest society of United States, like as a related to S&P, the dollar, US dollar index are be priced and bullish, right? Since the longer week, right? But at the Ichimoku, so many people of that for sure in terms of scalping of like intraday midterm, they took the years to buy dollar. So they short euro dollar, they short Aussie dollar, they buy USD CAD, they buy also USD yen, and they short so many people short indices. And I told you that to be very careful with that, because if you see again the chart of US dollar index, we are also stuck on this descending channel. And look at the curve of the lagging span, which is the close, the 26 period projected behind the graph, the close of the charts, which is projected 26 period before. So this curve, which is we call lagging span, it's very very important in the Ichimoku system. It's a filter, okay? And it just like show you to not be trapped by some of tricks that the Ichimoku can, or the markets, not Ishimoku, but the markets can give you, you know. So as you see on the close, look at it, it just like turn on the top of the descending channel here, and that mean as long as we stay here on the descending channel, I'm supposed that the USD line index could be now a bearish, okay? Because we fell on the top and it's a very high level here, and we test that like so many times. If I get out the Ichimoku for just one moment to show you like the new chart, you will see like so many indicative. Look at it, I can draw like a horizontal line here, so just to show you, you know. So here, that's we block. So you see that this area are very important, right? We test that like so many times, you know, and it could be like some a difference to use to trade all the stuff which is related to the US dollar index. So look at it, which is a very precise. And that's why I do care about the US dollar index, because some people would like to make some strategy to be long on euro dollar. I know that it's based off politics and based off also the context, but you don't have to just look on this side. You have to be focused on the global context of economic. And we know that the Fed talk about so many times, like over the last period, they talk about the short-term tightening policy. They talk also to hikes the rate interest maybe 3 to 4 times. They have like predicted before to 3 to 4 times, and after they review the prediction, they do 2 to 3 times, and now they re again recall 3 to 4 times. and that has been already priced in the chart for sure. And that's where you look at it here, and you see that the long-term trend for this chart, okay? But right now, we don't need to care about this chart because, as we see, we do kind of V-top, okay? It's a V-top here, and I will put in the black because, as we see clearly on the graph, you know, it's here we do a V-top. So V-top is a kind of reversal movement on the chart, on the technical chart for chartists, and that means the movement which is priced already before the entry on the tightening policy has been already made. That's why I told you every day that when we talk about if you have some rumor on the policy and the chart, the market has already anticipated and they'll all be already priced. Okay, so now if the Fed, like the Fed, show like very the intent to very to do like the right policy and to put the market on the new cycle of the tightening policy, there's nothing on it because we are already priced the movement. Actually, now with the same thing that we can have very worry about it, it's based on the geopoliticals and the supposed trade war on that. Okay, so that's we see the Fed has already made at short term the anticipation and to give confidence for investor to buy dollar, but now we've due to bad, very bad NFP and also related to not many, not quite good on the macro data for at the short term, we have kind of a retract for the US dollar, so that you have to very careful with that. And if you see at this very short term, like if I put 2 hours or 4 hours, you see that we can we did kind of a double top, as we recognize that, you know. So I can draw for you if you want. So here we test here so many times and then we break it, you know. And this is the neckline that we already break it. So very quickly, so we are in short term in we do a double top or maybe like triple top, okay? Because this is one top and this is one top again, you know. So we do we test the 12,800 line, which is like free time to test, and we couldn't like break it, so we completely fall off. So that mean that's why I told you to be very careful to anticipate it for bullish US dollar index, because it's not quite the time to do that. And if you do a strategy for bullish US dollar index, as the chart show you, but you have to be very meticulous. You could be wrong and do it like very bad trade, okay? So that's why I took my time to show you all the tricks that you have to very careful that I will report in Shimoku as well at the at we begin this show, okay, right there. So and you can see also here as Ishimoku, we stuck on the cloud and it's red, you know. Of course, some people we will say that we're starting to do the twist, but it's not a is we know we're not twisted again, okay? So just very careful with that. We stuck on the cloud, which is red, and also we stuck on the SSA. The SSB, it is the top positive top of the Ishimoku on the system, okay? So just very careful with that. I'm not I won't I won't be I won't buy US dollar, okay? Sorry, I won't short US dollar. I'm trying to buy it even and also either gold and all the and also trying to also buy potentially indices this week, okay? That's why I told you that this chart is the most important in financial markets. If you know by heart and you master the chart of US dollar index, you won't be wrong if you do like other analysis on different pairs which is related to US dollar index, of course. So let's now go to the USD CAD. So look at that. It's very nice opportunity to short at this moment as I re-recorded this this broadcast to short the US dollar index. No, no, it's like that's USD CAD, sorry, because we break it on the, also on the top. Do you remember at the last last show before the long break, I told you to be very patient and to wait that we're coming to test the dollar 34, 33, and after intend to short, that's what we made, right? We shorting here. I shorted here myself. I put some like an order entry. On order entry, so I'm just waiting that the market going to hit the top of the this ascending channel, which is so, the most of time it's finished by to going down. Okay, so that's why I put my here my my order entry for short, and it did, right? It's coming to in this line that we drew before that he came to test that, and now he break it. And the blue line here, which is the critical 11 month and monthly close, which is dollar 31 40 50, is the sorry, I will just break it. So it's the close of the June month. Okay, it's the close of June month. Though if you below the June month at the close, we're not trying to buy this market, right? It's completely evident. And that's why I show you before the graph of the US dollar index, and you see that US dollar index show you that dollar could be some of retract and it fell on the resistance, and it's translated to the USD CAD, or and USD CAD has like a great figures of employment this week. So Canada have like a boost to have to nice NFP, while the US dollar has some like very bad NFP, right? So that means CAD strengthened and US dollar will be like weakened. So you have to of course short US dollar CAD, right? So it's completely evident. So right now, if you short in US dollar CAD until maybe until the first take profit around the dollar 29, it could be a nice trade, pretty much the 150 pips to do that. Okay, so if you go to see on the relatively long, on the short term, you see that here is a more evident. Here we have like a ball vert to shorting, and now have some technical hurdles. Maybe here at again at a dollar 29 3000, but you have to be very patient to have like a nice entry point on the most off top, because we already break at this level, so we just can waiting some pullback here and shorting again. Or if you want it, you can put some short, but with very no effect leverage, okay, because you miss the right spot that you have to put some leverage. So when you want to trade on function markets, you don't have to put like effect leverage everywhere. Of course you will like burn your capital. You need to have like the very with the very nice spot to before to for trading. And at this kind of figures here, you don't have to put leverage effect, right? Because the market could reversal at any moment. So just shorting, you can wait if you want. That you have to kind of this scenario again, some retest here, and now we can shorting here and to going like on the like the previous low. Or if you the market didn't do that, you can also use to shorting directly, but no, don't put like leverage effect to protect your capital. That's the first rule of trader, okay? Don't lose money, okay? So here at the US dollar 30, which is the CFD of the Dow Jones DJIA, it's been also the while the same scenario as I show you before, because we saw that US dollar index seems to be weak right now, and it could be also boosted the index and the gold too. So we see clearly that this market is starting to be bullish, and also we saw that the green cloud of Ishimoku still there, and we got some a wide open of this the cloud. So at the long term, we know that the indices didn't stop to do his rally. So now maybe it's a time to buy index after the last rally for shorting again indices. I will let you know about that for sure. But if you again, if you remove indicator just for this moment, I will show you clearly, you know what is looks at Newt's beef like without Ichimoku. So you see that we stuck on again on the descending this descending channel. We're starting to break it. This orange line, orange zone here, these 23,540 to 24,780. It's I call intraday scalping zone. So at this zone here, if you trade in 5 minutes or 10 minutes, don't look to do some swing trading or midterm trading. Just do your scalping, okay? If I show you like more close in 5 minutes, you will see how it's look, right? Is this zone, you know? If you on this zone, don't try to trade some like long term or swing trading. Just doing scalping, buy the low, sell the high, buy the low, sell the high, until we progress at this zone. But if you break it, if you get out of this orange zone, then you can intend to buy the markets, right? So that means if you reintegrate and we get out of this zone, we have also possibly a bearish movement here. And also we can also go, if you get out of here, we can going also to do some a long-term movement until to retest the previous level high, okay, highest level. So that's why I want to show you. So there isn't change on that. So as you see, the more logical that, of course, the dollar has kind of retract. So that mean it could boost technically a US dollar index and also a gold. But look at here of the descending channel. So we know that the materialization is the most of the time we get out over here or the top. But we also have a tricky charts pattern. We have also a kind of pennant, right? We have kind of pennant here. If you see more closely, I will show you this ascending support oblique here. You know, it's gray, so we can have some of a triangle movement. So we can do that. We can do this kind of movement. I will also draw for you the scenario just to see my thinking, okay? And then we can break it, okay? We can break it to do this kind of pattern, okay? So that's why I recommend you to do very to be very careful with that, because this week for sure I will definitely look at it to trade indices and to trade to buy indices and also to sell all the to sell dollar, right? So buy gold, buy US dollar index, trying also to short USD CAD or USD yen, okay? It depend on which one configuration that I can get, but it's more secure to do this strategy, because we see clearly that the dollar is very fragile. So we don't like we don't play to be hero and to just buy to be stubborn and to buy US dollar index based on the recent macro data that we got, okay? So to finish this broadcast, of course, we saw that on the gold here. Take clearly, you know that this blue line is the monthly critical close, okay? This blue line here, and we bounce on it, okay? We bounce on it on this blue line here, because when the dollar was very strong, of course, we got the gold got some a massive like negative pressure. So when he coming here and he stop on this nice support like this support oblique here, it's played the role again. So for the I think for the four time, and we also starting to bounce it and probably to starting the movement. So the scenario as we play there, I also show you through the social media, like the scenario for the ascending channel, right? I do some post over here, and I showed people that it might be the time to buy gold, right? After a long moment, and also due to the context, economic context. So that's the goal, like play. It show us how the this green oblique forest plate has role of support. We test this line like free time, as we see on the graph, and then people buy, for sure the investor buy gold. But I'm very prudent with that, because we don't know again if it's clearly or definitely the scenario to do. We know that for sure in long term, gold as looks to trend to be bullish for sure, but which one it is the best bottom to buy, everybody didn't know that, right? We just doing some scenario, and if the scenario is really well played, for sure we're starting to do this strategy. But of course at short term and mid term, I'm bullish on gold, right? Because we see clearly that we bounce on it, and we do kind of technical pattern, kind of reversal. We got like a series of bearish candle. We do a long doji, which is the dragon doji, I think, long dragon doji, which is doing previously to the bearish trend. It's kind of reversal pattern that is shown here clearly, and also the lagging span also fell on the blue line here and is starting to come back to going up, right? So it's pretty much the same scenario that we got over here. So very careful with that. If you do scalping, it's okay, but if you want to buy this market, you have to be very careful with that, okay? Because I'm not sure that it's clearly the best time. For sure, if you buy it here, you minimize your risk, so you don't have to be worried about that. But buy the gold over here, it might be kind of risk. You have to be very careful about another trigger and signal and confirmation, and then you can entry in the trade. It's fine if you get it at maybe 1270 or 1280, it's fine. But it's more to do to waiting and to have like a better signal to buy gold to be profitable, you know. Don't rush it for that. Okay, so to finish quickly this show, I will show you like quickly the Eurobond. The Eurobond, we saw that the long term pattern is for sure is a bearish pattern, because we got some a bearish movement here. We stuck on the descending channel and also descending wedge, so we're supposed to get out over the top. So for sure at the long term, as we used to do analysis on that, we stuck on this purple line here, and we play the orange zone here, play the role as a support, right? And I told you so many times that just looking to buy the bottom. So we got the first time test here, after the second time here for the blue channel, we got it with the context, we going up, and then we stuck on the orange so the purple zone here. So my point of view of that is just to stay out this market, okay? We don't want to trade on this kind of careful chart here. So we're just waiting that we going to test the first top here before, and if you fail it, then you can shorting. My trading is very simple, okay? I'm not trying to be like hero or the best trader ever, right? I'm just winning the nice key zone, and also the real test of the zone before to entry my trade. So that's why I told you so many times to be patient and to waiting. That's if you going to this level, then you can entry your trade like very secure, because the rules is to not lose money, right? So at this moment, I will recommend you to stay out of this market. Of course, we know that on the long term, Eurobond has predicted to going up. The debt will continue to increase for sure. Not by the frequency and the rhythm, but for sure it will continue for to increase. So the way to do is just waiting that then first time you can retract until this level at the 161.30, then we can buy it here, or you can just waiting that we fail completely and to if you reintegrate it, you can short it for scalp if you do on the futures market. But if you want also you can waiting that you're going massively, and then you can also starting to short here if you fail it again, and if you break it, you can then buy this market, okay? Because fundamentally we know that the Eurobond is going to be bullish by the bias that the BC the ECB European Central Banks doing with Mario Draghi as through the policy of the QE, right? Or purchasing asset management. Okay, so now let's start now the recap for this show. So as I told you before, for a technical, I will just reduce the screen of my camera. Okay, nice. So at the long term, at the short term, sorry, for USD CAD, you have to be neutral for now. Just waiting that we got like the most the best top, then we can short it. Of technical long term is neutral to bearish. We saw clearly at the market. But Dow Jones now you can stay neutral if you want. Neutral that mean that didn't mean that the market we go anywhere. Neutral which mean that the market could go up or down, okay? Because we saw that at the orange zone, the wide orange rectangle zone, at this area, I don't personally trade this area because I'm not a scalper. I'm day trader or swing trader. Okay, so if you want trade in this zone, it's fine. But going with the scalping, right? You're just looking to buy each low because we know that dollar has very very weeks. So don't try to short indices while the dollar as very weak. So that's why I said that technical short term is neutral, and technical long term also could neutral to bullish because we're just waiting the highest top to shorting the market, because we know that technically we are and fundamentally also all index are the end, like ending on the cycle, and some economics predicted that we might have some in the second quarter of the next years a possibly recession, okay? So we just is already priced on the market, because that's why we have to be very careful and to waiting the precious line that we precious level or zone that we have to carry about that, okay? And gold is a pretty much the same thing. Technical short term, we clearly saw that it's past bearish to neutral right now. For sure, at the short term, right? But at the long term, it's neutral to bullish because we know that we fell 3 times on the this ascending support and the oblique, the green oblique that I show you, and then we can waiting that you have a better price, like a cheap price, because of course we are below the cloud of Ishimoku. Even the cloud is still green, but we are below the cloud. So we have to be very careful if you want to buy the market, because at any time you can have some reversal, okay? And Eurobond also we got a neutral to bullish, and technical long term we have also neutral to bullish. So it depends the way how do you want to trade for that. You can also waiting some like a key zone to buy as the key zone and the POC on the front of you here, and you can watching this video like so many times and after duplicating the same level at your chart, okay? So I'm very happy to present this this broadcast. Of course, if you like it, please don't be shy. Show that by a massive thumbs up. Share to your family and friend, And also, don't forget to subscribe to our Facebook page, YouTube channel. We have also Instagram and also Pinterest. And you can also be, you can call me also if you want, if you are a resident of Canada, at 514-943-4416. This is the direct line. Again, 514-943-4416. And also, you can send me a message also via the GST Facebook page Messenger. Okay. And don't also forget to put some reviews or comment to the review section at Facebook to help me for improve the quality of this broadcast that I present to you now each every Monday. Sorry again for the quality of the sound. My noise is not good, and we have also a construction site over here. So I hope that you're doing well. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we see you around to another video. It's François Ablé from GST Canada. It's 8:17 p.m. Thank you.